a demonstration of ice plant testing, and the aim of this experiment is to demonstrate the vapor compression refrigeration system. Performance of the vapor compression refrigeration system is captured by the term called as coefficient of performance, and you all know this. For us, what is important is before capturing the performance, we need to look at the components of the ice plant. Now, what is the ice plant? In the real life, you would come across ice factories where you would find that tons of ice is being manufactured every day. What is this setup? This is a small practical plant, help you to design to appreciate the concepts of ice plant, how it operates and how it is different from the regular domestic refrigeration system. So what you find here is the usual components. What are the usual components we talk about? So we talk about the four basic components. One is the compressor. So look at here. You'll find that in this blue box, Dadu sir is showing you this blue box. There is a black box which is the compressor. Okay, it's a bit dusty, but you can tolerate that dust. That compressor is the heart of the refrigeration system, and it would maintain the pressure difference. That is, it would maintain the high discharge pressure and the low suction pressure. Suction pressure, what we mean by suction pressure is the evaporator pressure, and the discharge pressure, when we say, we talk about the condenser pressure. So immediately in our mind, we should have this query that where is the condenser. So condenser is over here. Look at this condenser. The dusty portion, the black portion where you see the coil, this is the condenser, and you will find that there is a fan over there. So the fan is to increase the heat transfer coefficient. Condenser, this is the air-cooled condenser. Why is the condenser air-cooled condenser here? Because we are talking about a small capacity systems. If you look for the actual ice plant, the factory, ice factory, you will find that the condenser would be a water-cooled condenser. Okay. The condenser's job is to reject the heat to the surrounding, which it effectively does by using the fan. And the coils over there, they are not very visible, but that is what it is. The next component, that is from the refrigerant, would flow into the expansion device. This is the expansion device. Okay, this expansion device, what it does is that it maintains the pressure differential. That is, the condenser pressure is kept high and the evaporator pressure is kept low. There is something called as a flow meter, which is used for measuring the flow rate. Okay, why the flow rate is to be measured, that will come to. But for the present purpose, we would be simply locating these four components. Now, where is the evaporator? The refrigerant would flow into the evaporator. So, the evaporator is unique in the ice plant. The evaporator, which is in the household refrigerator, is different. But here you will find that this evaporator is housed in this portion, this box, which box has the evaporator coils. They won't be seen here, because what you will find is that there is some fluid. And this fluid which you see over here, okay, that fluid is the glycol fluid. Okay, I will explain you why the glycol is used. Just remember that for the present purpose, the refrigerant which is used in this setup is R134A, whereas the glycol which is being used over here is called as a secondary refrigerant. I will explain this in detail later. But just to note that this section is the evaporator section. Now, what does this evaporator do? Evaporator basically perform the main role. What is the main role of the ice plant? The main role of the ice plant is to manufacture ice. Now, how it is done? It is done by putting this can which Dadu sir will show you. This can is a can which is similar to the Kulfiwala can, where you can put the fresh water here, and the fresh water would convert itself to ice. Okay. And why do we use a can, and why don't we use the fresh water directly into this cabin? Okay. The reason is, if we use the fresh water directly here, there are two things. One is that we won't be having a better heat transfer when you are getting the ice formed over the coils. That won't be a desirable thing. And second thing is that we won't be able to achieve negative temperatures, much lower temperatures. Okay. So this is the reason why we are using this box. This box would house the glycol, and in this glycol, we would be putting the major quantity of fresh water for ice formation. Now, how do we perform this experiment? Okay, in this experiment, we would be performing two tests. One is called as a cool down test, and other is called as an ice formation test. Okay, before that, let us be clear that in this experiment, you will be getting the parameters. One is by actual measurement, and other is by analysis. Now, actual measurement, what are the actual measuring instruments which you see over here? First thing is, we need to
power which is consumed by this piston. There is a meter over here. So Jadhav sir is showing you this energy meter. This energy meter is similar to what you see at your homes, and you see that the unit of this is kilowatt hour. Kilowatt hour is the consumption. So one can note down the initial reading of this, one can note down the final reading of this, and one can note down the time period. Okay. So for both the tests, that is the pull down test as well as ice formation test, you will be taking the compressor power reading by the same method. Which is the method? You note down this reading initially, you note down this reading finally, and you take down the time interval. Okay. So that would help us calculate the power which is consumed by the compressor. Where is the compressor? Compressor is housed over here. Right? This is the important reading. Second reading is about the refrigerating effect. Now this is very interesting. In ice plants, we calculate the refrigerating effect in two ways. During the pull down test. Now what is pull down test? You see that in this, come closer, you find that in this there is simply a glycol solution. And there is no ice can being put over here. It means that this system is unloaded. You don't find the ice can loaded over here. When I put this ice can over here, it is called as a loading test or ice formation test. When I do this and if I perform the experiment, it is called as simply the pull down test. Now, how do you perform the pull down test and why is pull down necessary? Pull down means you pull down the temperature. Why is it called as a pull down test? You pull down the temperature from the ambient temperature to the negative temperature. Okay. And once this pull down is done, then you start the ice formation test, wherein once the temperature is pulled down, you need to pour in fresh water, you pour in fresh water and then you load the can. When you do this, that is called as ice formation test. Now how do you calculate the refrigerating effect when it is a pull down test? For doing that, we use the very basic expression which we have learned in physics, which is the sensible cooling expression. What is that? It is mCp delta T. Okay, mass of the glycol is known. Jadhav sir will measure the mass of the glycol, he would pour it in there, that would be the mass of the glycol. Okay. Obviously, we need to know the volume and the specific volume for finding the mass. Right? Then we need to know the initial temperature and we need to know the final temperature. So this can be recorded easily using the thermometer. The initial temperature of the glycol and the final temperature after the pull down test. That would give you the delta T. And the specific heat of the glycol, you can find it, you can go Google search and note down that specific heat, and that mCp delta T upon time would give us the refrigerating effect. So this is how you calculate the refrigerating effect when it is a pull down test. However, when it is an ice formation test, we do it differently. How do we do it? What we do is that we take fresh water, again Jadhav sir will pour the known quantity of water in this, you would be loading it in this. Now what would be the initial temperature of the fresh water? The initial temperature of the fresh water would be the ambient temperature, right? After the ice is formed, you need to measure again the temperature of that ice. If there is some water left, you need to note down the quantity of that water, and then by using your basic relation, I will explain you that basic relation on the board, you need to go take mass of the fresh water, specific heat of the fresh water left, into the delta T, plus we need to do the mass of the ice into the latent heat of the ice. Okay. So in this way you would be calculating both the sensible heat which is removed from this fresh water as well as the latent heat in the ice. If there is complete formation of ice, then there is no question of sensible cooling. Okay, but if it is the improper cooling and if there is some fresh water left, then we should note down the fresh water temperature also. Right? So this is how you calculate the actual refrigerating effect. In this setup, we also calculate the capacity, the performance by using the analytical method. And what is the analytical method? By using the pressure enthalpy chart. For that, you know that there are two pressure gauges required. One is the suction pressure, other is the discharge pressure. So note that there is a suction gauge over there. You can note down the suction pressure reading over here. You can note down the discharge pressure reading over here. Once you get the suction pressure reading and the discharge pressure reading, you can convert it into bars, add atmospheric pressure to it and convert it into absolute pressures. You have the property chart or property tables of R134a. You can plot the cycle by drawing the constant pressure line, that is suction pressure line and discharge pressure line on the PI air chart, you can also note down the actual temperature. How do you note down the actual temperatures?
So you see over here that there is an indicator and all the temperatures across the heat exchanger. Across the heat exchanger means what? Across the condenser and across the evaporator. Okay, that can be noted down from here. Once you note down these temperatures, you can plot the cycle on the pressure enthalpy chart and you would get the readings. Okay, you would get the enthalpy values. Why do you take this? We take this in order to calculate the mass flow rate of the refrigerant. Okay, I'll explain you now on this board.
As I have discussed here, this is the schematic of the ice plant, where we saw that there was a condenser, there is an evaporator, and there is a primary circuit wherein the refrigerant would flow through the compressor, evaporator, expansion valve, and condenser. This is R134A. And I had shown you the glycol solution housed in the container, and we had also seen these containers containing fresh water. Okay, so this is how is the schematic. Now, how do we do the calculations? That let me explain you. For doing the calculations of the pull down test, let me write down the expression. Pull down test, I told you that in both the tests, that is pull down test and ice formation test, the compressor work is calculated by taking the readings of the energy meter. The final reading, the initial reading, and the time converted in hours. Okay. So this is one way of calculating the compressor work. And when you are talking about pull down, as I said, pull down means what you do is you pull down the temperature of the glycol from the ambient to the negative temperatures. Note down the initial reading. Let us say this is P1, this is P2, and you know the mass of glycol. Mass of glycol, specific heat of glycol, and delta T upon time should give you the refrigerating effect during the pull down test. Okay. In the ice formation test, as I told you, you calculate the refrigerating effect by using this expression. What is that expression? Mass of the ice form into the latent heat of ice. L is latent heat. And if there is some fresh water remaining, mass of fresh water which is cooled down, I am talking about a case where you are not having complete cooling, into the Cp of this water into the delta T of this water. Okay. If you will find that if the temperature goes negative, then we need to take mass of ice, Cp of ice, and then the delta T of ice if it is negative temperature. Okay. So this way, it's just a sensible cooling, latent cooling, and sensible cooling. This way you can calculate the refrigerating effect. Power consumption is known and the ratio is the coefficient of performance. So this is called as the experimental COP, wherein we use the refrigerating effect calculated either during the pull-down test or ice formation test, and you get the power consumption. This is the COP experimental. Analytically, as I told, we need to draw the pH diagram, pressure enthalpy diagram for the refrigerant which is being used. We need to draw the suction pressure line, that is the evaporator pressure line, the condenser pressure line. Knowing the temperatures, you would get the state 1, state 2, this is your 1 to 2 compression, 2 to 3 is condensation, 3 to 4 is throttling, that is an expansion valve, and 4 to 1 is refrigerating effect. Okay, this way we can find the enthalpies H1, H2, H3, H4, and the COP can be determined as delta H across the compressor, which is H2 minus H1 upon delta H across the, delta H across the evaporator, which is H1 minus H4 refrigerating effect upon the compressor work, which is H2 minus H1. This would give you the COP theoretical. So this way one determines the performance of the system. And as I told you, the flow meter is required, because from the flow meter one can get the volume reading, VF reading, and we can read the specific volume at the state 3, and one can find the mass flow rate. So why is the flow meter required? The flow meter is required to determine the mass flow rate of the refrigerant, R134A circulating in the system. Okay. So this is a very interesting experiment, and
this experiment, when you are actually performing it, is really fun, because that would give you insights into how the actual ice plant works. Thank you very much. Bye for now.